Greetings, Earthlings. This is a quick look at a trumpeter kit of the Russian BRDM 2 early version. This isn't really a new kit, it's been out for a couple of years, but this is the first chance I've had to take a look at it. Now, the BRDM 2 was based on the BRDM 1. Surprise, surprise. The BRDM 1 was a fairly straightforward amphibious reconnaissance vehicle. It had a front-mounted engine and an open crew compartment and a machine gun mounted on it. The problem with it was that the long nose that it had to mount the engine inside there was problematic when it was navigating, and obviously being open topped and having the machine gun exposed, it made the crew quite vulnerable. So the vehicle was redesigned to become the BRDM 2. The engine was pushed to the back, the top was plated over, and a turret was designed and fitted, mounting, I think this is a 14.5 millimeter autocannon. One nice feature of the vehicles is these retractable wheels here. The idea was that these usually are retracted inside the body and just protrude underneath, and if the vehicle crests a bump, then these wheels stop it from bellying out. But they can actually be hydraulically lowered, and they were driven by chains, and so on very rough ground you got a bit of extra drive from these, just to stop it from bogging down. So quite an ingenious design. The early version refers to really some differences to the engine deck, and I'll show you that in the painting guide, but the later version had a revised engine deck with better cooling. So take a quick look inside. Now these vehicles are amphibious, and someone appears to have put that to the test with this box, because it's clearly been in the water. So it's obviously from the Atlantis sorting office of the Royal Mail. So first thing, some advertising bump, including advertising actually for the very kit that it's in, which seems a bit of a waste of time, but there we go. Painting and marking guide, and there's only one set of markings, which is simply for a Russian vehicle in this sort of mid green, and the only only decal really is this emblem for the Russian army. But I mean, these were very widely used, and you could, if you had the relevant markings, paint them and mark them for any of a number of Warsaw Pact or Arab countries. The differences I was going to mention between the early and late versions are mostly apparent here on the engine deck. The early version has these trapezoidal hatches here for engine cooling. The later version has a series of sort of mushroom-shaped cooling covers that fit on the forward part of the deck here. There are other sort of detailed differences, but that's the easiest way to tell the early and late versions apart. And some instructions, of course. I won't go through these in detail, but show there's a nice sprue map and some very clear-looking instructions, just showing the assembly sequence based on what appear to be the CAD models that were built for actually using to design the kit. What I did notice was that for the interior, and there is a fairly good interior for this kit, it includes this very large radio here for on the driver's side. I beg your pardon, on the commander's side. Now, I'm not convinced that was actually fitted to most of these vehicles. That looks like a command radio to me. There is a separate command version of this available from Trumpeter, and that might well be the one that needs that radio. So I'm not going to fit it to mine. Obviously, you can fit it if you want. You've paid for it. You might as well. And it'd probably look lovely painted up and all the detail picked out on it. But just to say that I don't think that really needs to be in there. It's also missing a few sort of details from the inside, like the inertial navigation system that these things had that allowed them to find their way around. But again, just that's just a sort of small silver box, so that wouldn't be too hard to add. All right, now the kit proper. I shall move the box out of the way to make it easier to focus. It's all moulded in these sprues of typical nondescript grey that you normally get from Trumpeter. This one has the rear bulkhead, the propeller tunnel for the propeller that drives it in the water, some transmission detail, the hydraulically operated splash guard, and other sort of bits and pieces, the propeller here, and the steering wheel. The next sprue has the hull sides and the wheel arches, more transmission stuff, and the floor for the interior of the vehicle. And some parts. This is that large radio that I don't think is actually required for this version. Some ammunition boxes. Two other radios. Now, this smaller one, I suppose, could plausibly be the inertial navigation system, although it doesn't look like the one that I've seen in these. And there's the parts for the gun and the mantlet for the gun, and a big billhook for the side. And the turret shell. Notice that the turret has no upper hatch, so you can't actually get in and out of the vehicle through the turret. I think that's a bit of a shortcoming, but it was certainly very cramped in the turret. The hull roof, you notice that the hatches for the driver here and the commander are offset slightly, and that's to make room for the commander's sight here. And then two identical sprues containing wheels. These are the main wheels, these are the belly wheels. Under this bit of sort of foam wrapping, you probably can't quite make it out, but there are the chains that are used for the chain drive for the belly wheels. You'll have to take my word for this, that this is basically a clear sprue, all very nicely wrapped and packed separately. That's very nice. Well done, Trumpeter, for that. And finally, the rear of the hull and the engine hatches. That does it for the sprues, but of course there's the upper and lower hull. This is the upper hull, very nice sort of single moulding there, very good indeed. And the lower hull, again, a single moulding, lots of nice detail there. So that should be a fairly straightforward thing to put together. We've got tyres. We've got four vinyl tyres here for the main wheels. Now, if you've seen my other videos, I think you'll know that I do not like vinyl tyres very much, but unfortunately, that's all you get nowadays. Four more vinyl tyres, oh joy, for the belly wheels. And a very small etch fret. This contains, if I can get that to focus, thank you, that contains a grill for the propeller for the water jet. And this is the front of the turret. This is the mantlet plate for the turret, and the other few details. And there is a piece of string for the winch, and a length of copper string there for presumably for tow cables. And finally, there is a set of decals. Now, this is interesting because there's actually more decals on here than are called out in the painting guide. The painting guide just calls out these Russian army emblems, but in fact there's a number jungle set here for, you probably can't see it, it's white on a very pale blue background, but there's numbers here for bought numbers for the sides of the vehicle. That's a nice touch. And also what appear to be, I think these are Russian Marines flags, and it looks like some airborne troop flags as well, markings as well. So there's probably more to that than is just available on the marking guide. Okay, well, that is a quick look at this kit. It looks like a fairly straightforward build. It looks like a very nice kit indeed. I shall have fun putting this together. If you've seen my other video, you know that I actually had the opportunity to clamber around inside one of these and go for a ride in one a few days ago. And I've got quite a few reference shots. I can tell you actually that these things are like a bit like a reverse TARDIS. They're a lot smaller on the inside than they are on the outside. And considering how much effort it takes to clamber up and actually get inside one of these things through the roof hatches, I have to say that it's very disappointing at how little space there is inside. But yes, interesting machines, and I think they are still in service with some countries. So if you're interested in these, there's this kit, there is a BRDM2 late kit that Trumpeter also make. They also make a command version which doesn't have the turret, and I think they've just come out with the, I can't remember what it's called now, but it's basically an anti-tank version that mounts some spandrel anti-tank missiles on the top as well. So yeah, plenty to choose from, very widely used vehicles. This kit looks really good, and the interior detail gives it a very nice touch. So miles better, I think, than the old Dragon offerings, which are the only things you could have before. And well worth, this one was cost me under £20, and was certainly well worth the money for me. So anyway, that's all I have. I hope you enjoyed that. If you have any comments or questions, please post them. And in the meantime, I'd like to wish you all happy modelling, and goodbye.